En welkom. Welcome to a new episode of Inno Update. My name is Maarten Kos en Inno Update is all about corporate innovation. Today's topic is dual innovation and it's a topic which is coined by Dr. Ralph Christian Orr and Frank Mattis, ambidexterity. So if you want to know more about ambidexterous organizations, check out one of the previous episodes I've made on innoupdate.com. So just a recap, you have the core, which is trying to exploit the current business model. And on the other side, you have the innovation hub, the corporate startup teams who are exploring new business models. And of course, these two types of the organizations have different focuses. So most of the core is done within the business units. They are running their current business model, making money. Most of the time, the development of the new business models is done in a corporate setting, in a corporate innovation team, a corporate innovation hub or a lab. If you look at the running the business model, it's all about mitigating risk. And for the new and the explorative teams, it's all about uncertainty and how do you manage uncertainties. And of course, there's a different method. So you can do the stage gate approach really good in the core of your organization. But when exploring new stuff, you have to go to the lean startup methodology, build, measure, learn. And if you want to know more about that, there's also a previous episode about that topic in innoupdate.com. So these are the different types of actually kind of playing fields within a good innovative organization. And the question, of course, is, does it work? So what you could do is look at the last 3 to 5 years of your organization and what did you invest, what kind of money did you invest in radical innovation and incremental innovation? What activities were funded, what startups, what projects, and what is the current business impact of these activities, of these projects? So if you want to look at incremental innovation, the impact must be between one and three years. If you have more radical innovations, impact should be in like 3 to 5 or maybe even 10 years if you are developing a new business model. So for most companies, this is really tough because it's hard to identify the impact. But if you can identify the impact, most of the time it's very, very low. So how can you change that? Well, if you look at the different playing fields, you have here on the left bottom side the core and right on top the new stuff. The core is all about the existing business model. The new is creating new stuff, deploying new technology and exercising new business model. But the most important playing field is in the middle. Is reshaping the core. So these are technologies which may be new to a business unit, and these are business models which are relatively adjacent to the current business model. But this is where the magic happens. If you look at the periods, the core, developing the core, incremental innovation is between one and two years. Reshaping the core is between 2 and 5 years, and creating new business models could take like 5 or even 10 years. So what you want to do is everything which is developed in creating new stuff, you have to scale. It's easy to do the experimentation and the testing, but you have to scale it. And that to be done in the playing field of reshaping the core. And if you do incremental innovation, you have to adapt your business model. But then if you want to make use of it, you have to reshape the core. So if you look at this picture, you can clearly see the three, what we earlier defined as the three horizons of innovation. If you want to know more about that, click on the episode Three Horizons of Grow. But Christian Orr and Frank Mattis don't talk about horizons, they talk about playing fields. And if you look at these playing fields from a different perspective, you can see that everything which is developed new, like new ventures, innovation hubs, has relatively, in the beginning, little business impact. If you look at what's happening in the core, that's making the money for the organization and has big business impact. So in the middle, you have this kind of white space. Let us take a look at this playing field just between the exponential, the radical innovation, and the incremental innovation. This white space is all about industrialization. It's about taking these pilots, these new innovations, and making it scalable, making it repeatable, making it like an industry. Because if you are in the venture, in the innovation space, you can do all these kind of experiment and lean startup methodology, but now you have to make it in a kind of factory way. This second playing field is also about making it to the market. Of course, your product has already proven a solution fit to a market fit, but now you have to scale it. You have to cross the chasm, and that's important. So it's all about scaling. And if you look from the other side, like the incremental innovation, it's about transforming current business models. So the people in this kind of areas need to know all about exploiting, but also about exploring. And if you take a look at the management style, you have to be aware that not all of the founders in the corporate startups can deal with that. So sometimes you have to change and transition the management of your corporate startup. And of course, it's also about growth hacking. And Ralph Christian Orr and Frank Mattis call it lean scale-up. And what is the lean scale-up all about? Well, the lean scale-up has three components. First of all, it's about leadership, dual leadership, about leadership and who knows all about what innovation is all about, but also what it is to be running the company. They have to be a role model. They have to allocate the resources in the right way. Then the second part is the methodology. So you have to know for sure if this corporate startup, for example, is mature enough to be scaled. Are you not doing it too early or maybe too late? How do you design a process of scaling? So the methodology is also important. And finally, it's all about collaboration. Collaboration between these two, the exploit and the explore part of the organization. You have to formally align the agile and the process-driven worlds. And that takes leadership, dual leadership. So what are my thoughts about dual innovation and ambidexterity? I think most of the companies are doing it already, but it's so hard to do it well. It also depends on the culture of your organization. If you have a research and development focused organization, then you can do it in a different way than if you have more a risk averse kind of organization. So if you want to learn more, I will post some links to blogs from Frank Mattis and also, of course, Ralph Christian Orr about this topic. And if you want to do a real deep dive, just buy the book Scaling Corporate Startups. That was it for today. I hope to see you back next week with a new episode of InnoUpdate. And in the meantime, keep innovating.